He's so arrogant, I cannot even get 5 meters close to him.
She's always angry, she's just so annoying and I hate her voice.
He's so full of himself.
He's always trying to call everyone's attention. He just wants to be the center of the freaking world.
Labels, labels, and labels. We all know them.
We live in a world of constant misunderstandings and miscommunication. And today, I will explain you exactly how you can change that. This is a hard pill to swallow, but please stay with me and listen to the whole concept of this video because it will help you to understand human relationships at a much deeper level and in a way you haven't heard before. We just want to hang around with people who do not represent a threat to us. And that's a lazy approach to life. If you want to succeed and you want to better yourself at a really fast speed level, you need to change your approach in life. What if I tell you that you need to start hanging out more with those people that annoy you? Because right there is a big life lesson for you to learn. I know it's hard, but leave your fat ego aside, because your ego never wants you to evolve in life. Your ego just wants you to remain in your safe comfort zone, and there you won't grow. Wanting to be around with people who value us and with people who tell us the things we want to hear, it's immature, it's unrealistic, and it truly hurts us way more than it helps us. It actually makes us weak because it feeds our ego massively. And then we think we are way better than what we really are. We fall into the trap of thinking that we deserve more and better things than what we actually do. It's like that saying that says, "Tell me what do you presume and I will tell you what you are missing." You know when someone attributes a certain virtue to themselves, but before long they begin to show signs that contradict everything they have been preaching about? If you have to say it, you aren't that. If you have to show it, especially on social media, it's because it's not really there. It's like I don't value myself and I go through life saying, "Hi, value me, hi, value me, hi, value me. I am this and that and I've studied this in university and I have this master and I live a house with views to the sea and the mountains and la-di-da-di-da." But the amazing thing is that the change starts with us. Let's be the ones who change the way we do and we perceive things to be able to change the direction of our destiny. What about giving us the chance to see things from a complete different angle? What about start seeing our enemies and the people who make us feel uncomfortable as our biggest life teachers? What about challenge us to get out of the comfort zone of thinking, "He is an idiot, I won't spend a second with him." You don't see people the way they really are. You see people the way you are. What you see now, it's a combination of all your past experiences. And that's why human relationships are so complex. Because if what you see depends on your past experiences and what that other person sees depends on his past experiences too, then you say A, he understands C, he answers D, and you perceive C. So yes, we live in a reality where we all speak different languages. There is the way things objectively are, and then there is the way we think things are. Basically, the way we subjectively see things. Just in case this was too confusing, I will define these two terms. Objective means based on facts and measurable data. Unbiased, factual information. True facts, reality. Subjective means information based on opinions, beliefs, judgment, points of views, and mood. On one side, we have the reality, and on the other side, we have the altered reality that we see. For example, on this side, we have this piece of objective information. Over the last 22 years, there has been constantly more men than women in the whole planet. And then on the other side, we have my Aunt Maria. And she says, because there is more men than women, men abuse their power over women. And apart from that, all men are unloyal. So she thinks men are unfair and unloyal. So this is what Maria subjectively thinks. After all her past experiences with men, and these include her father, cousins, uncles, her boyfriends, Maria has formed an image, a stereotype towards men. But let me tell you something. One thing is the men, and another very different thing is what happened particularly between you and men. Everything Maria sees in men is a reflection of all her past experiences with men since the moment she was born. And this just goes to show how people project their own past experiences as the reality they believe. And people always look for ways to prove their beliefs just to reinforce their reality. It's the reality. My Aunt Maria, she will go through life just seeing unfair and unloyal men everywhere she goes. She won't even notice the nice men around because she believes they don't exist. She has no time and no eyes for them. The problem is that most of the behavioral patterns work automatically. Our repetitive patterns comes from the information that resides in our subconscious mind. If you want to prove subconsciously that all men are bad, you will live life stumbling upon bad men, men who reinforces your theory. We see what we really want to see and not what really happens. For example, a mom will say, "My son is amazing, he's not the problem. The problem is all their friends. They are such a bad influence for him." Yes, sure, right? That kid is just as his friends, and that's why he spends so much of his time with those kids. They are similar. End of the story. Let's go back to Maria's example, where she states that men are unloyal and unfair. Let's say now we have this other woman that always had and keeps on having an amazing relationship with her father. She will have a complete different image and concept of men than what Maria has. And she will probably never be Maria's friends because they belong to different realities and they vibrate at a very different level. Thinking that our negative preconceptions are true is just a mix of fear and ego, of not wanting to go again through the same life experiences that hurt us in the past. I won't have a relationship ever again because I found my ex-wife cheating on me. So now I go here and there having a date, playing with women just to have some sex, but then I don't want to keep on seeing women anymore because I don't want to develop feelings for anyone again in my life, because women, they are all the same. I don't want to feel something for someone again in my life. And that's how we make the whole world of opportunities around us a tiny, dark, gloomy shithole, just because we don't want to suffer ever again. Suffering is part of life. You need to navigate painful situations. Everybody has to do that. You are not the only one. That's just life. We can learn a lot from painful experiences. We, for example, can realize that our priorities were all in the wrong places and in the wrong order in our lives. Pain processed efficiently brings mountains of knowledge and wisdom to our lives. It makes us better. And because we get better, we can enlighten the lives of the people who are around us. Unfortunately, pain that is not processed at the right time becomes poison, and we take that poison wherever we go, and we spread that poison wherever we go. If in the past relationships ended up bad, I can analyze myself objectively and think, where did I fail? And after the period of grieving, I can say, even though in the past things haven't gone my way, in the future things can be great. Why not? Again, if you do not change your mindset, you will keep on creating your destiny with your past experiences, with your limiting past experiences. It's like your present doesn't count. Your present doesn't exist in the slightest. You just live in the past or in the future, and you are throwing every single day your present in the garbage. Usually, when we are angry, we are reacting out of proportion. And please let me explain you this with an example. Let's say you are at work and you apply for a specific project, and for X reasons, your boss gave that project to another coworker. You feel so much anger that you cannot function. All you do is just being there, ruminating for hours and hours about what happened and thinking, why did that happen to me? Chances are that you are reacting out of proportion, and this situation is throwing you to your past, to when you were younger, and let's say your father didn't trust you. So even though you cannot connect that consciously, the reason because you are reacting out of proportion is because this that it's happening right now reminds you of how untrusted you felt years and years ago. You are reviving a painful past experience. You are taking a memory from the past out of context, and you are trying to bring it to the present. And that's exactly why your current reaction doesn't match today's specific scenario at all. We aren't just a blank canvas. We are full of bones that are bleeding. We are full of preconceptions, and that's the language we speak. The problem is that we are speaking that language with people that doesn't have anything to do with our past. So we take things continuously out of context, and that's why our reactions just don't match in the slightest with what is happening. People think, what on earth is she all about? She got her menstrual period or what? She's just so traumatic. So there we are, all speaking different languages because we all have different perceptions of things. We live in a world of constant misunderstandings and miscommunication, but I will explain you how exactly you can change that. We usually run away from people that generates on us a negative perception. We all make very quick assumptions on people, and we determine in just a matter of seconds if we want to spend time with them or not. A person that just with its own presence disturbs us. A person that very easily take you out of your chill zone. A person that causes you instant rejection. That can be an amazing teacher for you. A spiritual teacher. An amazing mentor for you. Stop there, because there is something there for you to learn. And if you learn that lesson, then that situation or that person itself won't be in your life anymore. But if you try to escape, that situation will keep on popping up and popping up in your life, represented in various different people. Why? Because life always wants to impulse our own mental development and our evolution. We normally consider a mentor as someone who inspires us, as someone who is loving and wise. And even though that is true, we also have to learn to recognize those mentors that reflect to us our dark side. We all have light and darkness. We all have good and bad qualities. Our mentors, those people that have the potential to teach us the most about ourselves, are those people that act as a mirror or a screen of our own dark side. We just simply don't want to see our own defects. It's so much more easier to find our defects on others and then criticize those people for what actually lives in us. It just sounds twisted, but we humans like to make things so much more complex than what things really are. We should be like this. I found this problem, I will fix it. I found this problem in me, I will fix it, end of the story. But not, I am great, I am not the problem. The problem is outside me. The problem is him, and the problem is her, and the problem is all of them. I invite you now to grab a pen and paper and write the name of that person you can't see. That person that just when it pops up in your mind as a thought, you get in a bad mood instantly. Write on the paper the name of your darkness mentor, of that person you can't stand. That when you know that person is going to the dinner party tonight, you say, oh, no, I won't go. It's okay, I just stay home. And please have in mind that that person may be causing that same negative effect and aversion in a lot of other people. But still, that is not a valid reason to underestimate how that person can give you a priceless life lesson. And also, please don't forget that now there might be another person watching this video that is writing your name on his or her piece of paper. You are the darkness mentor for someone else out there. Someone out there might feel disgusted with your comments, with your presence. Let's just stop thinking we are special. This is bi-directional. Our darkness mentors are those people that mirror our dark side that we need to enlighten. And then we, with our personality, with our behavior, are the mentors, and therefore we act as a mirror, reflecting on others the dark side they need to enlighten. No one is that amazing and perfect and sacred and nice and pure. I will give an example to explain this bidirectional reflection even better. A treats B badly, and B hates A for that. But then B doesn't realize how similar he actually is to A. Because in other environments, B treat other people just as badly as A does. Maybe your boss treats you bad because you highly depend on that job and you don't want to be fired, or because you need the money, or whatever reason. There's not much that you can say back to your boss if you want to keep your job secure, right? But that doesn't mean that then you are an angel, because maybe in other areas of your life you treat other people badly. So this that you don't like from that person, which is your boss, actually exists in you more than what you wish. The fact that you don't treat bad the exact same person that treats you bad doesn't make you an innocent person. Maybe you're abusive with a brother, with a sister, with a cousin, with your parents, with your partner, with the pizza delivery guy, with a salesperson. There is a quote in the Bible that I will say it in Spanish because I couldn't find it in English, and it goes something like this. Deja de señalar la paja en el ojo ajeno y quítate la viga que tienes en el tuyo. Which, with my own homemade translation, goes like this. Stop pointing out the straw on someone else's eye and first remove the beam you have in your own eye. This also means something like, most people prefer to confess others' sins. At the end of the day, our enemies are not the people that hate us, but the people we hate the most. And in that hate is where we need to stop and make some introspection work. Also, I would like to add to this topic something I find very interesting. The only person who can know who you truly are is just you. Because as I said before, what other people see in you is just a pure reflection of what lives in them. Then, of course, there is a very small portion of the whole population of the world that has the ability to see things objectively and not subjectively, and therefore they see life and circumstances with so much clarity. And I hope that me and you, if it's not that you already belong to that group of people, can be at that level of evolution one day. Following the line of this topic, I have this other video where I explain the exact 7 principles that will teach you exactly how to deal with conflicts and conflicted people like this.